Hi guys and welcome to this week's vlog. I hope you're all doing really well. So I'm just currently sat on the floor and I'm about to do my makeup. So I thought I would do an updated makeup routine with you guys. So I'm gonna start off with my primer. I'm using the Laura Mercier Pure Canvas Power Primer Supercharged Essence. So this is a silicone free primer and this has some amazing skincare goodness in this. I think it's got like hyaluronic acid, blue algae or something like that. But anyway, this is like their ultimate primer and I just love it. So while I'm doing my makeup, I thought we'd have a quick catch up. So over the weekend, we heard the news that the UK is going back into lockdown on Thursday, which is obviously crazy, but something that we all have to do to look after each other around us and stop the spread of the virus. But yeah, my heart really does go out to all of you guys. I know so many of you struggled last time and it is really hard with so much change. I know a lot of you have been furloughed or some of you are key workers. So yeah, I'm sending extra love and I'm thinking about all you guys. But I just hope you're all staying safe. By the time this vlog is out, we would have gone into the lockdown. So for foundation today, I'm gonna be using my Bare Minerals Powder Foundation. I've been loving this at the moment. It's such a natural finish. It's really buildable as well. So I just put a little bit into the lid. And then I use this Bare Minerals brush. This is designed for the foundation, but you can just use any normal brush, like a kabuki brush. I put a tiny bit on the brush and then I swirl it around like this. And then goes onto the skin. It's actually so weird how this works. I don't really understand it, but I just really like the finish it gives. Oh, and this is in the shade Golden Beige. I'm gonna try to do more vlogs like I did last time. Lockdown is gonna be different for me this time because obviously last time I was on my own for like, I don't know, 4 or 5 months, because B went down to Brighton and I chose to stay in London for various reasons. My mum works in the NHS and she's on the COVID ward a lot, so there would have been complications with me going home. Also being at home and I could work, and I just think if I couldn't work during COVID, I would have gone a little bit crazy. Anyway, B is now with me. She has been part-time furloughed, so she's gonna be working at home some days of the week and then just doing her thing on the other days. So it'll be nice to have a lockdown buddy this time. This foundation, look how natural it is. In real life as well, you just can't tell that there's anything on your skin. It just looks like you've got perfect skin. And then for concealer today, I'm gonna be using my Laura Mercier Flawless Fusion Ultra Long Wear Concealer. So this is a bit of a thicker, higher coverage concealer compared to the Rimmel one, which I also do love. So yeah, you only need the tiniest bit. You really don't need a lot. And I'm gonna blend this in with my Real Techniques Soft Accent Brush. So yeah, we go into lockdown on Thursday, which means we have this week to go crazy. No, I'm joking. Obviously, we'll not be going crazy. But yeah, it is kind of good because it gives us a few days to kind of get everything sorted, ready to go into lockdown. But let me know what you guys are doing during lockdown, whether you're working from home or if you're a key worker. Let me know what your plans are. I feel like this lockdown is quite different though, because we all do know what to expect. Last time I thought it was quite scary because none of us knew kind of when it was gonna end. It was also unknown, but I feel like everyone's a lot more chilled out this time. I'm just gonna go on to my brows using my Bare Minerals Brow Master in the shade Cocoa. But yeah, I do feel quite lucky in the sense that it doesn't change a lot for me because obviously I work from home anyway. I don't really go out a lot, to be honest. And obviously we haven't really been able to meet up with friends like in big groups anyway. So I feel like there isn't gonna be a lot of change. Obviously we can't go like shopping and go to restaurants and stuff, which I will miss, but it is so important for us all to isolate and do our bit. But yeah, I am really thinking about everyone because I know how hard it can be mentally. And yeah, I just think we've really got to look after ourselves, look after the people around us, reach out to friends and family who might be on their own or might be struggling, and try focus on the positives, which I know can be hard. I did ask everyone on my Instagram yesterday sort of how everyone was feeling, and there was a big mix of responses. So however you're feeling, I don't feel like you're alone. Everyone's going through something different. Okay, so for bronzer, I'm gonna use my Rimmel Natural Bronzer, and this is my Hourglass double-ended brush, which is very handy. And I'm just going to bronze kind of by your contour, I guess. But what I think we should all do is set some lockdown goals. If you are in lockdown, of course. I know not everyone is, and some people are working and stuff. But if you are at home, I think we should create some lockdown goals. Let's make some vision boards for the month of November. Obviously, at the same time, don't put pressure on yourself, because I know like last time people were going nuts, like working out every single day, making 20 loaves of banana bread. And if you want to just do nothing and relax, and that is what's gonna do the best for your mental health, then that is what you should do. You know, like a goal doesn't have to be something big. It can literally just be look after my mental health, have self-care days, etc. Okay, and I'm going to use my bronzer and this brush from Morphe. This is the E23 brush, and just go all over my eyelid. One of my goals during this lockdown is just to smash out content. I want to produce loads of like reels and hopefully YouTube videos. Yeah, just get loads of content done really. So for blush, I'm going to use the Charlotte Tilbury Cheek to Chic in the shade Ecstasy. And then this brush is my Real Techniques multitask brush. And then of course for my mascara, I'm going to use my Marc Jacobs at Lashed. This is actually on its last legs, so I need to get a new one. Right, the plan for today is I'm going to show you guys some bits that I picked up from Topshop, some really nice autumnal bits. This video is a sponsored integration with Topshop, so I'll show you those bits later, which is very exciting. And then I also want to film a reel today. I'm thinking of doing something like 5 ways to style mum jeans or something, so yeah, I need to do that later. What else do I need to do? Okay, and then for lips, I'm going to use my lip combo, which I've been using since life began, and this is the NYX liner in Leon and the gloss in Madeline. And there we go. Just need to do my hair. Just gonna curl the front pieces, I think. My lips look so much bigger when I wear Invisalign. They proper like stick your lips out and make them look really plump, and I'm here for it. By the way, Invisalign update. I feel like I haven't done one on YouTube in a while, but I'm on my 9th out of 11th week. So I should get them off, fingers crossed, mid-December, but the dentist did say that if they aren't quite how she wanted them to be, then she might add a couple more. But hopefully mid-December. But yeah, I think they're getting really, really, really straight. So that's exciting.
Our weekly odd box has arrived, and look how good it is. Pumpkins, and how cute is this mini pumpkin? Absolutely love that. Lots of lovely kale, oranges, and they did kindly gift this one to us. We normally buy them, but they have gifted this one, which is very lovely. Look what Bea just made me for breakfast. So lovely. Thank you, Bob.
You're welcome.
Okay, so I'm gonna do a really quick Topshop haul for you guys. I placed an order yesterday, I think, and there's some really gorgeous autumnal pieces that I think you guys are going to love. So I'm gonna do a little mirror try on clip kind of thing, starting off with what I'm wearing now. Yeah, I am really proud to say that this video is in collaboration with Topshop. Yeah, let's go.
So first up, we have this cute little collared top. It's in this really beautiful khaki rib, and then you've got the zip going down and the little collar here. And yeah, like you guys know, I've said this before, but khaki is, as far as colours go, my favourite colour. Obviously not including black, white and nude. But I just love how autumnal it is, how seasonal it is, and yeah, I really like the fit of this. I went for a size 4, and I just think it fits so nice and snug. I really love how tight the sleeves are. I always think that tight sleeves are a very flattering look, and also they're something that will keep you super warm. But yeah, I just thought it was really nice, and I'd probably style this either with like leather leggings like I am now, or this would also look really cute with like some mum jeans, maybe black mum jeans with a belt and a big black coat. Oh, and by the way guys, I'll link everything down below in the description box as always. Okay, then next up we have another black jumper to add to my very, very large collection of black jumpers. But I just really loved the detailing on this. I just thought that the frills on the shoulder were really nice and just a really pretty detail to add onto a jumper. I also think it makes it look a little bit more expensive compared to a plain jumper. So the material is like kind of a compact wool, so it's quite like nice and thick and stretchy, which is lovely. The sleeves come in at the end, as you can see, and it also does come in at the waist slightly. It's definitely not cropped, but it's not long either. It just kind of fits nice and snug around the middle. And yeah, I picked this up in a size 8 and it fits really perfect. I know it's a bit early, but I actually think this will make a really cute Christmas day kind of jumper, because if you're like me and you don't really tend to wear much color, but you still want to look a little bit more like extra, the frills really do the job. And I also love the collar. It's a nice kind of snug fit collar. Doesn't come up too high, so you can still see a little bit of neck. But yeah, I feel like this looks very expensive, and it was only, this was part of their Idol collection, which I think is their slightly more premium collection. I might be wrong, but yeah, it definitely does feel and look premium anyway. Okay, I think you guys are gonna really like this one. So it's this gorgeous big black puffer jacket, and it honestly just feels like a walking sleeping bag. It is so comfortable. Oh, ignore my slippers. It's just so lovely big and comfortable. It's got these huge pockets at the front, so perfect for putting in like keys and stuff. I know that a lot of us will be going on a lot of daily walks now we are in lockdown, so I think this is perfect and I'm going to be wearing this on the daily. It's also got a hood attached. Really nice big hood, can protect you from the rain. We love that. And then it's got like this big kind of collar inside, which again makes it just so much more snug and cozy. But yeah, I'm a big fan of puffer coats and I really, really love this one. So I picked this one up in a 10. I always like my coats to be a little bit oversized on me. I think this was £80, I could be wrong. So a little bit more on the expensive side, but honestly the quality feels amazing. It's nice and soft. You can tell it's gonna keep you very, very warm. And yeah, so I definitely say that it's worth the money. This is the kind of coat that you are going to have for a long, long, long time as well. Okay, how cool is this next outfit? I think it is really nice. So I'll start off with the jacket. So it's like this denim jacket kind of vibe. It's got a raw hem and then these like silver buttons going down. I just said to B, look how small it is for a 12, and she goes, Kate, you got it in a petite. So that explains why it's small. But yeah, definitely go up quite a few sizes in this if you want to have the oversized look. It's really nice though. It's like a washed denim kind of vibe and I just think it looks really chilled and relaxed. And then I've just paired this with my Topshop plain, basic, everyday hoodie. I've got so many of these now. It's just such an easy throw on, especially just in the winter when you want to layer up. And I size up in the hoodies as well. I think this is in a medium. I'll put all the sizes down below again with the links. And then these are my Topshop leather leggings that I have shown you guys and worn about a million times. You're probably sick of hearing about them. And then these boots. I don't know if I've shown you these boots yet. These actually weren't in the order. I've ordered these maybe a couple weeks ago. And they have become my absolute faves. I just love them. So as you can see, they're quite like a chunky biker boot like platform. But yeah, they don't look too big on my legs. And I am quite fussy with boots because I hate it when they look too big on me. Just because my legs are so like skinny and stuff. But yeah, no, these don't look clumpy. And I just really like the way they're kind of a sock boot, but in leather. They're just so cool and I've also worn them so much and they are super comfortable. But yeah, they're all rounder win. Ignore the light if it's doing weird things. It's only 2 o'clock in the afternoon and again, it's like dark outside, so I've got two ring lights on. But yeah, I think this is a really nice outfit and it'll also make another nice kind of daily walk outfit because it's comfortable. And yeah, I just think all black outfits are always completely foolproof. Okay, so I've saved my favourite outfit until last. How gorgeous is this maxi brown cardigan? I just think this is so autumnal and just so cozy. I absolutely just love it. It's a really soft, lovely material and it's quite like a chunky knit as well. I'll show you up close. Oh my god, it actually matches my hair perfectly. Look, it's like a nice thick rib. What size did I get this in? Let me have a look. So I got this in a small just because it's quite long and I'm only 5'4", so I wanted to make sure it wasn't going to like trail on the ground. And I also like the way it's got little slits up the side of the leg here, which kind of makes it look like a bit less of a blanket and more of a flattering cardigan. I've only had it on for like a minute and I am getting very hot though, so I feel like this would make a good alternative to a coat. And it's definitely going to keep you super toasty and warm. But yeah, this is definitely my favourite part of the haul. I just think it's the coziest thing ever. This would also make a lovely lounge cardigan, like for when you're working at home or just like days around the house. I think this with like a black top and some black joggers will be such a nice home outfit. So yeah, that is the last thing I've got to show you guys. Absolutely loved everything I picked up. Don't think I need to return anything or like change sizes or anything. And yeah, everything was perfect. So I can't wait to style everything. I'm actually now gonna film a reel because I wanna do some like daily walks outfits. Doing this haul has inspired me to create some walking outfits because yeah, I definitely like to be comfortable on my walks but also look quite cute, especially when it's going to be like the only chance you get to leave the house in a day. So yeah, that's my plan now. Good evening guys, I haven't spoken to you in a while. I kind of got into a bit of a working whole day and time's just flown by. Anyway, I'm in my pajamas now, about to get cozy. These pajamas are from the Napco and how beautiful are they. And I've got my UGG slippers on. So now I'm going to light some candles. Bee's just making dinner in the background. Tonight we're having a veggie roast, which is very exciting. Oh my god, guys, look at this amazing spread that Bee's done. You're the ultimate housewife. So we have a bit of a veggie roast going on. I absolutely love the way Bee put the gravy in the teapot. I think that's a great touch. Oh my god, this looks so yum.
Dig in.
Wow, I don't even know where to start.
Yeah, sorry.
So what's in the squash?
Well, I forgot to add that one thing.
Yes, all right.
And then I've got maple, carrots, and rose potatoes.
Oh, lovely.
I've never really had gravy.
Veggie life. Okay, right, let's pour the gravy. What's all steaming up on my camera? Wow.
Oh my god, the carrots are so good. They're all spread apart.
Okay.
Oh, I should probably butter that, shouldn't I?
So, B made some cooking mixture, and we're now gonna put them on the tray together.
Why are you laughing?
Okay. Thanks, Lucy, for the top tip. I love how you looked at me and then I said my mum did it. Okay, bucket, spoons.
No, what are you getting a spoon for?
You can spoon it on there.
No, you're getting it with, you have to roll it with your hand. That's why I said, make sure you have clean hands.
I would rather do it with a spoon. I want to go.
All right, fine. Well, that's what the recipe told me to do. So if this fucks up and you think I'm bad at baking again, it's not.
Go on then, get your dirty hands in there.
No, it said to use 3 tablespoons per cookie.
That's going to be humongous, B.
No, because I didn't have any baking soda. What are you doing? You need to make sure they're not that close together.
Yeah, but how, would you be able to fit 5 on there?
No, we'll fit 6.
In the go?
No.
Okay, fine, yeah.
Here are the cookies, guys. Bye!
Oh, I didn't check that on before.
See you later, senorita.
She will just know by the look, then, won't we? Kate!
They're better when they're raw.
No, it's got raw egg in it!
Sorry? A little bit longer. Oh my god, these look amazing. I think they're ready, Bob.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Stand back, it's gonna be roasting.
Okay. Wow! Freshly baked cookies and Devil Wears Prada. How perfect. What's this right now? Good morning, guys. Oh my god, it's so bright. I'm gonna move. Hang on. Okay, yeah, there we go. Good morning, guys. So I've got a day working from home today. This morning I've been doing my emails and admin and stuff, and then I've got a call with my manager in about 5 minutes, and then I need to film some story content. Then I might go take a photo because I've got no photos at the moment. So I've just had a call with my manager, and now I'm sat on the floor because I'm about to film an ad for some stories I'm doing with Ted Baker. I'm doing the ad over on my Instagram, not on my YouTube. But yeah, they've got some really like nice gift sets and stuff for Christmas. So yeah, I'm just showing those, and it's so hard of ads to do them in a way that doesn't sound pushy, in a way that doesn't sound like fake, because I genuinely love their products. Like my cupboards are full up with all of their bath and beauty stuff. So yeah, like it's about trying to get in the information that they want in the brief, so things like prices, dates, stuff like that, whilst trying to sound like normal and not like you're trying to sell something. So that's the plan for now.
Guys, I hope you're all doing really well and having a lovely day.
Just driven to Chelsea and we're going to take some pics now. I'm walking along trying to scout a location, and I left my phone, no camera, I left my camera in the car. That's why I'm on my iPhone.
Hi.
Thank you.
So we've just finished shooting and we grabbed a hot chocolate. Is this car going to reverse into me?
What the hell?
Oh my god, I'm actually gonna freak out.
No, he's not gonna.
And yeah, we took 2 outfit photos. That's why I've got changed. We took 1 for B as well. What should we have for dinner tonight?
Don't know, what do you fancy?
I wouldn't mind an Indian, you know.
Really?
Gotta feel like I'm surrounded by really big cars. Hey, she's got a nice outfit on.
Who?
That girl in the skirt.
No, she doesn't.
Yes, she does.
What, the metallic skirt?
Oh shit.
Sorry. You know yesterday when we were on the tube?
Yeah.
And
you said, why did you just say that?
Yeah.
I did actually say something and I forgot to tell you that it was a joke.
Oh my god, B. Wait, I'm not going down here.
Wait, what did I say?
You said deleted.
Oh, I went deleted. Yeah, and you were like, why did you say deleted? And I didn't. Obviously, you know the story.
Oh there. My god.
Yeah.
Yesterday, I thought I was going crazy because B goes deleted in my ear. And I go, what did you just say? And B goes, nothing. That's, do you know what that is? That's gaslighting. You just gaslighting.
No, I was meant to say to you after.
I really thought I was going crazy. I was like, that's so weird.
I know, because I sat there laughing to myself and then I got distracted.
You were so convincing. You're not never normally that convincing.
Yeah, I know. Well, I am, actually.
No, you're not. You're terrible at lying.
No, I'm not. I'm so good. No, I'm actually, all the time.
Yeah.
I'm joking. I don't really.
I'm sitting there questioning myself.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Good evening, guys. So we are home now and we just ordered an Indian takeaway, which is exciting. I've just got a bit of work to finish up with because obviously we've been out all afternoon, so I've got a few bits to do. I've got to do some gifting selects for like upcoming campaigns. I need to do some invoices. What else do I need to do? I just need to do some like content organizing, working out sort of when things are going and where they're going. How good is this, guys, as well? I went through every single one of my emails the other day, deleted absolutely everything, like all the spam. I had some unsubscribed to everything, and I feel like my soul has now been cleansed. So really satisfying, really recommend it.
I just feel like myself.
B's going back to work tomorrow, so I'm sad. Our takeaway has just arrived. What did you order? Did you order the same as me?
Yeah.
I've ordered a paneer tikka masala, I think. Thank you. Oh, B, it comes in a cute little bag. Look. Where are we?
Oh, that's so cute.
Good morning, guys. So today's smoothie is so, so delicious. Really recommend this recipe. It is 2 bananas, a teaspoon of cinnamon, oats, oat milk, honey, and a handful of spinach. You cannot taste the spinach at all. It just tastes like a lovely, banana-y, cinnamony smoothie. Guys, I haven't been able to stop eating these things. They are vegan pastrami-style sandwich slices, and they are so good. What are they made out of? They've got like chickpeas, beetroot, that sort of thing, and they are so addictive. So today's plan was to go out and shoot outfits. We are obviously going into lockdown on Thursday, so we can shoot outfits up until then, but the shoot actually got cancelled, which is really frustrating because I've got a outfit that I need to shoot for a brand today and I need to post it today, and I obviously would have shot it earlier if I'd known today would have been cancelled. But whenever these inconvenient things happen, I always try and remember that these things do happen for a reason, which might sound really silly, but I honestly believe that the universe always, always has your back. So my shoot today got cancelled because I could do something better, or because if we had shot today, I wouldn't have liked the content. I don't know. There's always reasons for these sort of things. So I don't let them get me down and I move on with my day. And yeah, it's just a good way of switching on mindset. So, saying that, the plan today, I need to first of all do my hair, and then I need to take some outfit photos, and then I need to do another campaign, and then I also want to film a reel, like an unboxing reel for my Chanel bag on my Instagram. Okay, so I've taken my pictures and I think I like them. This is a classic mirror selfie. This is my outfit. I showed you guys this in my last vlog, and I think that vlog is going live today. So, super cute, very autumnal outfit. And now I'm going to shoot a Bondi Boost campaign whilst my hair is looking nice and fluffy. Now I'm going to move on to my Bondi Boost campaign, and I thought I would take you guys along with me, show you what I do and my process behind it all. So, I start off by stalking the brand's Instagram and kind of seeing what they like and what's on brand for them, because obviously even though the content is for my page. I like it to be on brand for them as well. So as you can see, they do kind of send like ideas in the brief, but it's also good just to look at their Instagram. A little look at that, try and get some inspo. And then I will have to work out what I'm going to wear. So in the brief, they said natural colors or like a dressing gown or something, or pajamas. And then I've also got to figure out like the location where I want to do it. So I'm thinking either like a mirror selfie again, just on the floor here. Now I'm just looking at my content and what I've produced for the brand. Obviously I've been working with them for a good year now, so I don't want to be repetitive, but at the same time I like to be consistent. This was one I did sitting on the piano, product behind me. Another one on the floor, product in front of me. And then this is another one, like a selfie kind of shot with product in my hand. I'm thinking mirror selfie, yeah. Sorry, ignore the dust thingies on my screen, I need to clean it. And I'm thinking I could do the pic in B's room. The light in B's room is always so much better than my room because she's got the two windows, which is lovely. Okay, so half chosen my outfit. I'm going for this top. These joggers were the first option, but the thing is when you sit down in these, they really bunch up like here. So I'm gonna change these for something different. Okay, and now I have tried doing a mirror selfie in here. Like I said, it didn't quite work. So I'm thinking of doing one sitting on this chair. So I've got my ring light tripod thing, my phone attached on the side here. And it's definitely like such a trial and error kind of thing. I just kind of keep on moving around until I've got something that I think works, and then go from there. Okay, so what I do first is I'll test the light, see if the light's good. If the light's not good, I'll adjust the angle, but the light is good here. And then I will work on the background. So right now the background's looking a little bit messy with this. Okay, so I wasn't feeling it in, oh, the light's really weird. So I wasn't feeling it in B's room, so I'm now sat here at the table to see if this will work instead. Got these pretty flowers in the background. Just need to get the mask and my clicker. So I use this little remote control. I got this from Amazon, and you literally just click it and it takes a photo on your iPhone. So the post was looking a bit bare, so I've just got some more products just to put in the background. Okay, so then once I'm happy with like the layout, the setup and everything, I just start shooting. I hold the little clicker in my hand and you can't see it because it's quite small. And then I'll take about 10 photos, have a look back. They'll often look really different after taking them, and then you can kind of work out the light and stuff. So the photos are slightly dark, so I'm gonna just put the ring light on. So I finished with my Bondi Boost content. Now I want to film an unboxing for my bag, and this is my very non-technical setup that I've got going on. This is all very precarious. I've attached everything with sellotape, so I'm hoping this is going to go well. Oh my god, ignore how shiny my face is. On days that I shoot at home, I don't wear any powder because I just feel like your skin looks so much better in photos when you don't wear powder, but on camera it doesn't look great. Anyway, so I've just done the little unboxing and I'm now going to quickly edit it and then upload it to my Instagram. Okay, so it's all edited and I've just popped it into Tezza, which is the app I use for filters and editing, and just brightened it up a little bit. So now it's all ready to post. Okay, so I finished filming and shooting for the day and I've got quite a lot done today. How many things have I shot? 3 things? But yeah, I'm feeling happy about that. Anyway, now I need to edit a video and then I'm gonna head to Sapphire to get another facial. But I've taken you guys to Sapphire so many times now, so I'm going to end this vlog here. I really hope you guys enjoyed it and I'm sending you all extra love this time because we are going into a lockdown. And yeah, I know so many of you guys struggled through it last time, but we're all in this together. I'm going to be uploading as much as I possibly can. Yeah, I love you all so, so, so much and I'll see you in my next video. Bye. Mwah.